是真的，你也是爱我的，那你为什么让我遭受那么多的苦痛呢？
And if you truly love everyone in this world, then how come you're letting most of the people go to hell? Why not save us all?
第二个问题是，如果你真的是爱每一个人，这世界上的每一个人，你为什么让那些大部分的人都要到地狱里去呢？
And if you're real, then why don't you give us miraculous signs like in the Bible?
如果你是真实的，为什么你不能像在圣经当中讲的那样，你给我行一些神迹呢？
And what about the people who haven't heard of Jesus? Are you sending them to hell for their ignorance?
那些没有因为无知没有听说过耶稣基督的人，难道你也把他送进地狱吗？
And lastly, how can there be only one true faith?
最后一个问题就是说，难道这世界上就真正只有一个真理吗？
For all of these questions, little by little, God showed me that it all boils down to sin.
其实所有的这些问题，一点一点的神让我明白到，这些都归结于自己的罪，这世上的罪。
As for human suffering, it is a consequence of sin, and sin is man's fault.
其实人类的罪，人类所受的苦是因为我们的罪。那罪呢，也是自己我们人自己造成的。
But what I have learned now through experience as a believer is that God won't take away the suffering, but He'll help you through it to make it bearable.
作为一个信徒。我现在所能理解的是，神不会把我们这些痛苦拿走，但是他会帮助我们经历这些痛苦，而且使我们使这些痛苦能够承受。
For me, there have been a number of situations that I couldn't have pulled through without His help. I would have just given in to sin.
作为我来说，在我这人生的经历当中，如果没有神的帮助，我是走不过来的。
And as to God sending people to hell, 2 Peter 3:9 says.He says, He is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, but everyone come to repentance.
至于神为什么让人下地狱这个问题，在彼得后书3:9说，主是宽容我们，不愿有一人沉沦，乃愿人人都悔改。
Most importantly, God has done everything to keep us out of hell, going so far as sending His Son Jesus to die, paying the penalty for our sin.
其实最重要的是，主，我们的神是竭尽全力让我们不下地狱，甚至差他的儿子耶稣来死，为我们偿还罪的工价。
For us, death is the ultimate price, and because God loves us so much, He paid it Himself.
也作为我们自己，死亡是我们要付的终极代价。但是因为主神爱我们，如此的爱我们，他亲自为我们付了这个工价。
As for giving us miraculous signs like in the Bible, signs are not a guarantee that anyone will believe.
至于他的那个问题，为什么神不能像在圣经当中写的那些神迹一样，在我的生命当中显神迹？他的回答，他现在明白到，即便是神迹，也不能保证每个人都相信主。
In Jesus' parable of Lazarus and the rich man asked Abraham to send the also dead Lazarus to his brothers to warn them.
大家就记得在路加福音第十六章当中就讲到，就是拉撒路和一个财主的故事。
But Abraham replied, "They have Moses and the prophets. Let them listen to them." "No, Father Abraham," he said, "but if someone from the dead goes to them, they will repent." He said to them, "If they do not listen to Moses and the prophets, they will not be convinced even if someone rises from the dead." That's Luke 16:29-31.
在路加福音第十六章讲到的这个是财主和拉撒路的故事。他这里讲到是，当这个死了的这个妇人，当看到这个同时也死了，但是已经在亚伯拉罕的怀抱里的这个穷人的时候呢，他就恳请亚伯拉罕说，你可不可以把这个拉撒路呢去复活以后去告诉我还在世的兄弟，让他们就警告他们。但是亚伯拉罕的回答在路加福音第十六章29-31是这样说的，亚伯拉罕说，他们有摩西和先知的话可以听从，他说，我主亚伯拉罕呢，不是的，若有一个从死里复活的到他们那里去，他们必要悔改。亚伯拉罕说，若不听从摩西和先知的话，就是有一个从死里复活的，他们也是不听劝的。
According to the world, seeing is believing, but according to God, believing is seen. As for the people who haven't heard of Jesus, Romans 1:18-20 says, the wrath of God is being revealed from heaven against all the godlessness and wickedness of men who suppress the truth by their wickedness, since what may be known about God is plain to them because God has made it plain to them. For since the creation of the world, God's invisible qualities, his eternal power and divine nature have been clearly seen, being understood from what has been made, so that men are without excuse.
至于他的问题，前面的问题就讲，如果有些人他根本就没有听说过耶稣基督，那他也会被神送到地狱里去吗？这回答是在罗马书第一章第18到27节，原来神的愤怒从天上显明在一切不虔不义的人身上，就是那些行不义阻挡真理的人。 神的事情，人所能知道的，原显明在人心里，因为神已经给他们显明。自从造天地以来，神的永能和神性是明明可知的，虽是眼不能见，但记着所造之物，就可以晓得，叫人无可推诿。
And then again in Acts 17:24-27 says this. The God who made the world and everything in it is the Lord of heaven and earth, and does not live in temples built by hands. And he is not served by human hands as if he needed anything, because he himself gives all men life and breath and everything else. From one man he has made every nation of men, that they should inhabit the whole earth, and he determined the time set for them and the exact places where they should live. God did this so that men would seek him and perhaps reach out for him and find him, though he is not far from each one of us.
创造宇宙和其中万物的神，既是天地的主，就不住人手所造的殿，也不用人手服侍，好像缺少什么，自己倒将生命、气息、万物赐给万人。他从一本造出万族的人，住在全地上，并且预定预先定准他们的年限和所住的疆域。
In short, God is a just God.
其实简短的讲，就是一句话，神就是神。
He will not send innocent people to hell because they haven't heard of Jesus.
神不会把一个清白无辜的没有罪的人，只因为他没有听过耶稣，就把他送下地狱。
If they do end up going there, it's because they refuse to surrender to God and thereby reject the only way of life.
如果他们真是走到了这一步，下了地狱，那真的是因为他们拒绝在神面前降服，并且呢，拒绝这个神是唯一的一条生命之路。
Acts 4:12 says, "Salvation is found in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given to men by which we must be saved."
使徒行传第四章第十二节说，除他以外，别无拯救，因为在天下人间没有赐下别的名，我们可以靠着得救的。
As for having one true faith, there is only one truth and one way to God. Jesus says in John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
至于我以前的问题，为什么这世上只有一个真理？ 其实这个问题很简单，耶稣是这样回答，在约翰福音第14:6，我就是道路、真理、生命，若不借着我，没有人能到父那里去。Jesus
also says in John 10:9, I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. He will come in and go out and find pasture.
耶稣也这样说，在约翰福音第10:9，我就是门，凡从我进来的必然得救。 并且出入得平安，得草吃。
As God opened my eyes to these things, little changes started to occur in me.
神真的是通过这些事情打开了我的心眼，一点一点的变化在我心里发生了。Certain
things that I used to find pleasure in now bothered me, and loneliness grew.
其实以前我觉得感觉到快感的事情，现在觉得真的是非常的累，缠累着我，并且我这种孤独感在增长。
I started feeling out of place because I no longer felt right in doing the things I used to do, but neither did I feel right with God, and so I kept pushing him away.
我总是觉得不对劲，因为我不再觉得我以前所做的事 是对劲的。